हेलो क्लास, हाउ आर यू पीपल डूइंग? सो वी हैव ऑलमोस्ट कंप्लीटेड द चैप्टर दैट वी स्टार्टेड लास्ट टाइम. ओके, द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज पॉलिनेशन, राइट? इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट, ऑफ डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द फ्लावर. आई हैड गिवन यू होम टास्क, बट आई डिड नॉट रिसीव एनी वन ऑफ द होम टास्क फ्रॉम यू पीपल. सो we'll be carrying forward with the same chapter. Today we will be discussing about the types of flower and pollination. Okay, we have already discussed about the parts of flower, so let's start with the types of flower. Now your flower can be divided into two types. What are those types? Bisexual flower. Another term for bisexual flower is a hermaphrodite. Okay, and monosexual flower, or it is also referred to as unisexual flower. Okay, now let us understand what is bisexual flower. Bi means two. Bi means two. Okay, so in case of bisexual flower, you have both male as well as female reproductive part. Okay, you have both male as well as female reproductive part in case of bisexual flower. Okay, example is your hibiscus, mustard are the example. You go through the other example that's given in your book also. Okay, now another one is your monosexual flower or unisexual flower. Uni means one. So in such kind of flower, you have either a male or a female reproductive part within a same flower, not both of it, either a male or a female reproductive part. So those kind of flower are referred to as monosexual or unisexual flower. Example is your maize and papaya. Okay, so those were the types of flower on the basis of presence of reproductive parts. Whether if both is present, what is it referred to as? Bisexual. If either one of it is present, it is referred to as unisexual flower. Okay, now that's all about the types of flower. You will go through the definition and example. Now moving on to the pollination. What is pollination? We will be discussing now. Okay, so let's carry on with pollination. Now what is pollination? Now before going to what is pollination, do we know the male parts of male reproductive system in case of plants, and do we know the female reproductive parts in case of plants? I hope you know. If you don't know the parts, then better go through the videos that I have posted earlier. Okay, because in order to understand pollination, that particular video is essential. You have to know the parts of male and female reproductive parts of plant. Okay, now carrying on with the pollination. Now pollination means transfer of pollen. Where is pollen present and what is it part of? Pollen is present in anther, and it is a male reproductive part. Okay, your pollen, they have male gametes of a plant. Okay, so this pollen has to be transferred to the stigma, and stigma, it is the female reproductive part. Okay, it has to be transferred to the stigma. That process of transfer of pollen from the anther to the stigma is known as pollination. Okay, now why is pollination important? Pollination is important because only after the pollination, your male gamete is going to fuse with the female gamete that is present within the ovule. Okay, so for the fusion, one prior step earlier is your pollination. Okay, only after the pollination takes place, your fertilization is going to take place, and after the fertilization takes place, only the new plant is going to be formed. Okay, so it's a very important step for the reproduction in plants. Pollination means transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma of the plant. Okay, now there are two types of pollination. Now keep one thing in mind, pollination occurs within the same species of plant only. What do you mean by same species of a plant? With that I mean pollen grain of, for example, let us take the example of rose and hibiscus. Okay, to rose and hibiscus, pollen grain of rose, even if it goes and falls on the stigma of a hibiscus, fertilization is not going to take place. Fertilization will take place only if the pollen grain of a rose goes and falls on the stigma of a rose plant only. It has to be within a, it has to be of a same kind, plant of a same kind. Only then fertilization is going to take place. If a plant is, a plant are of a different kind, for example, I give you the example of rose and hibiscus, even if stigma goes and falls, pollen grains goes and falls on the stigma, those pollen grains are going to disintegrate. Further fertilization is not going to take place. You have to keep that thing in mind. It occurs only within the plant of a same kind. Okay, now moving on to the types of pollination. There are two types of pollination: self-pollination and cross-pollination. Okay, now what is self-pollination? Now self-pollination, in case of self-pollination, you look at this figure A. In case of self-pollination, pollen grain, this one is representing your anther which contain pollen grains. Okay, anther with pollen grain. Okay, within the same plant, if the pollen grain goes and falls on the stigma of a same flower, it's known as self-pollination, because it's happening within the same flower. That's called self-pollination. Okay, anther of the same, pollen grain of the same flower is going and falling on the stigma of the same flower. That's happening within the same flower. So this is known as self-pollination. Now self-pollination occurs in case of bisexual flower. I already told you what is bisexual flower, right? Bisexual flower means both the reproductive parts, that is male and female reproductive parts, are present in this kind of flower. Okay, example, I gave you the example of China rose. So if the pollen grain of same flower goes falls on the stigma of the same flower, it is known as, within the same flower, it is known as self-pollination. It happens only in bisexual flower. Okay, now another one is your cross-pollination. Now what is cross-pollination? In case of cross-pollination, it takes place between two different plants but of a same kind. Okay, like I told you, pollination occurs within fertilization to occur, as your pollen grain of a same kind has to go and stick to the stigma of the same kind. So though the plants are different, but they are of a same kind. That, let's take the example of rose plant, two rose plant. Imagine this to be the flower of one rose plant and imagine this to be the flower of another rose plant. Okay, so if your anther from one flower of one plant goes and sticks to the stigma of another flower of another plant but of a same kind, so this type of pollination is known as cross pollination. Now it occurs in case of monosexual flower. Monosexual flower means they have only one of the reproductive part, not both. Okay, either male or female. So this kind of plant, your cross pollination is going to take place. I gave you the example of monosexual plant, are your maize, papaya, all these are monosexual plant, because they have, their flower contain only one reproductive part, that is either male or female reproductive part. So in those cases you have cross pollination is going to take place. Okay, Now, for self-pollination, you do not need any kind of pollinating agent. Pollinating agent. Now, what is pollinating agent? Now, pollinating agents are those organisms, or it can be non-metallistic thing also, which will help in pollination. Okay, agents which helps in pollination is known as for carrying the pollen grains to the stigma. Okay, there are different agents which helps to carry out this process. So those agents are referred to as pollinating agent. Now for self-pollination, most of the time you don't need a pollinating agent. Okay, but for cross-pollination you need a pollinating agent, because one pollen grain from one flower has to be transferred to the another flower. That's why you need a pollinating agent. Okay, now what are the different pollinating agents? Now different pollinating agents are your insects, okay, birds, wind. In case of aquatic plants, it would be water. Okay, that's why the flower are very colorful, attractive. Some of them even have nectar in it. Nectar means those fruity, juicy the secretion in a flower. Okay, they have nectar in it. They are smelly or scented. Why? In order to attract insects and birds. Okay, because when they come and sit either in the wings or legs, your pollen grains are going to stick, and when they go to the next flower, they are going to dust out those pollen grains into those flower, thus helping in pollinating, transferring the pollen grains. Okay, so those are the pollinating agents. For cross pollination, most of you need pollinating agents. Okay, so that's all about this chapter. This chapter was very short one. You just had to go through the different parts. Did you do the homework that I gave you last time regarding the parts of flower? Because I have not got any one of those. So you go through the different parts of the flower. What is pollination? Differentiate between the two types of pollination. Differentiate between the types of flower, that is bisexual flower and monosexual flower. Only few topics are there in this particular chapter. Okay, better go through this. So that's all for today. Thank you.